Hello everybody, my name is Peter Hadley. I am the President of the Asia Pacific region for ADP. ADP is one of the world's largest payroll and human capital management providers. We service over 800,000 clients in more than 140 countries around the world. I have been leading the Asia Pacific region for ADP for close to 3 years now and have been with the company for more than 18 years. And it's my pleasure to be with you today. People leadership has never been more important than what it is right now. I think there's a couple of areas I'd like to highlight. One, I think, is the skills of empathy and understanding your employees and caring about your employees as a leader. I think that's always been something that should have been there, probably was there to some degree. But I think in this environment, it's truly become fundamental with respect to successfully getting things done. For employees to know that first and foremost in their manager or their employer's mindset is their own personal welfare and safety. And the second point is that the pandemic has enabled a little bit of a return to traditional management responsibilities and allocation of those responsibilities. So whereas sometimes central corporate leadership teams can become a little bit empowering in terms of centralizing decision making, in a pandemic situation where everybody is working remotely, where the circumstances are dramatically different, location by location, country by country, never has it been more important for empowered, local, strong decision-making to be made and to be supported versus driven by central structures. Central management and top management is becoming much more responsible, I think, for supporting local leadership in their decisions on the ground, for providing governance and providing resource allocation. But really the fundamental requirement, I think, to navigate through this situation successfully is strong, devolved local leadership with respect to the situation that the people are in that location. So payroll, like many industries, has changed dramatically as a result of these circumstances. So there's a couple of things. I think the first one is just the way payroll is done. Payroll has traditionally been very much a head office, in the office, function or with an outsourced provider, you know, done from their offices. Obviously, the vast majority of people in the world of payroll are not working from their offices anymore. They're working remotely, they're needing tools to be able to work remotely, be that, you know, VPN connections, laptops, things like that, but also access to the materials that are needed to do their work. Payroll is quite a technical activity, a very precise activity. So the way payroll is being done has certainly changed dramatically as a result of the pandemic. Although in saying that, I think from what I observe, the adaptation that's been made in the industry has been fantastic. I think secondly, what we've also noticed is certainly helpful intervention, but adding a lot of complexity from many governments. So governments are certainly looking to, and have been for a number of months now, looking to support, in many countries, support employment levels. So in doing that, they're providing various subsidies and programs to keep people in jobs, whether it's furlough, subsidization, and various things like that. What that requires, you know, logistics-wise to enact it is a lot of changes in legislation that impact payroll, whether it's law, whether it's the process of payroll, the types of employees, the employee categories. As an example, in China, in the first quarter of calendar 2020, we had over 200 regulatory changes in that quarter versus 85 changes in the same quarter of the previous year. And in the previous year, that was the single largest individual income tax reform period that the Chinese government had ever done. So the volume of change and complexity is dramatically increasing, certainly with good intentions, but by governments, but staying on top of this has really been a big challenge, I think, for payroll people and the payroll industry. Added a lot of complexity and a lot of value, I think, to what these functions are delivering, because, you know, when you get past maybe medical and health, the health industry, I think the security of people knowing that their pay is being delivered to them on time and accurately in such difficult economic circumstances is really critical to many people's lives. I think technology is certainly a tool, it's an enabler. I don't necessarily view it as the solution in and of itself, but you know, what I've seen is a lot of existing technologies have become much more mainstream, much more, you know, higher utilization levels, whether it's video conferencing, whether it's apps. Certainly self-service for users of technology is something that's been around for many years, but you know, necessity forces an increase in use, and certainly a familiarity that many people perhaps who were not lovers of technology or were stuck in their ways have been have been forced to adapt to technology. So in our industry, certainly what we've seen is a great advertisement for digitization, essentially. You know, payroll, there's a lot of filings, there's a lot of, traditionally been a lot of paperwork. You know, payment many years ago, by the way, still in a number of countries today, has been done by check. You know, the delivery mail systems, you know, transport and courier systems have been heavily overwhelmed, and we've seen in many parts of the world, you know, delivery has, you know, in more traditional physical means has become, you know, complex and disruptive, I guess, to a continuous business process. So technology has been a great enabler to doing that. It provides much more instantaneous results. And it certainly, you know, with the advent of the internet and bandwidth speeds and so on in most countries, has enabled work to continue much more seamlessly in a remote environment than I think anyone thought was possible. Technology has been a great enabler to a seamless experience through these changed circumstances. So things like electronic payslips, electronic reporting, transfer of funds instantaneously bank to bank without any need for paper instructions or paper checks, or cash for that matter. We're moving much more to a cashless society. Certainly payroll is one of many industries that is benefiting significantly with respect to employees and workers enjoying, you know, a much more seamless experience, an on-time, accurate, enjoyable experience with respect to receiving their pay, and I think also adds a lot of certainty, which again is important in the circumstances in which people are living at this point in time. I think the what the pandemic situation has led us to, I think, is a lot of focus on what's right in front of us, the very short term, and that's been necessary for many companies, certainly many industries that are either battling for survival or just trying to get to the next month, the next quarter, to make payroll, to make their debt repayments and things like that. But I think it's critical that HR leaders do not allow the necessary focus on the here and now, and that sharpened focus on the here and now, distract or detract from their medium and long-term plans, which were in place before the pandemic and will become critical once the situation hopefully normalizes and we move out of the pandemic and back to a recovery situation. So things like talent planning, getting the skills, the training, the learning in your organizations, diversity and inclusion objectives, again, these are the things that can easily slip by the wayside, particularly in changing employment environments where perhaps downsizing is happening, whether that's temporary or whether that's more structural in nature. So, you know, I would certainly urge all HR leaders and business leaders in general to at least keep one eye on the medium term and the long term. Don't throw those old strategies and those plans out, because they're going to be critically necessary, if not to manage through the near term, where understandably attention may shift a little bit more to tactical matters, but they're going to be very, very critical in the success of companies in the medium and long term. So please, my advice is to keep those things front and center in your mind, continue to execute on them, and make sure that they don't slip unintentionally or intentionally by the wayside as a result of the disrupted period that we're in right now.